In this video, I will show you how you can make motion-activated NeoPixel RGB shoes. Without any further ado, let's get started. Let's start with everything you need to build one. Well, of course, you will need a pair of shoes. Besides which, you will also need WS2812B NeoPixel RGB LED strip. You can get them online, I will put all the buying links in the video description. Next few things you need are Arduino Nano, 18650 lithium ion cells for powering the system, a spring vibration sensor. If you don't have one, I have a video on how to make one at home, so you can check that out. And lastly, few wires, a soldering iron and a hot glue. Once you have all the material, we can start building. Firstly, I took the shoes and started measuring out how much LEDs I can fit around the shoes. For me, it was about 44 LEDs. So I cut two pairs of LED strip, each with 44 LEDs. Now using some hot glue, I glued them around the shoes. Make sure you start from the behind, so we can attach the wires later on. By the way guys, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, so you get notified every time I upload. After gluing them around, it was time to work on some electronics. I took two 18650 lithium ion cells and placed them in these tiny black spaces, which are optional. You can even use some electrical tape to hold them together. These cells are 4.2 volt each, so now we will connect them in series to form a 8.4 volt battery pack, for which I used my soldering iron and this nickel strip. You can also solder a small piece of wire. Now connect the positive end of the battery to the VIN pin of the Arduino Nano and the negative end of the battery to the ground of Arduino. This will directly power the Arduino Nano using batteries. At the moment, I don't have a switch, so I just cut the ground cable and later on I will twist the wire for powering the system. Once that is done, take the vibration sensor and solder one of its leads to the 5 volt of Arduino and the other to the digital pin 2 of Arduino. Now that is complete, take your shoes and connect 5V to the 5V, ground to the ground and DIN pin of LEDs to the digital pin 13 of Arduino. Similarly, repeat the process for the other shoe as well, and that is all we have to do for the electronics. Now it's time for uploading the code to our Arduino. While uploading the code, just change this line of the code and enter the number of LEDs you have on your shoe. For me, it's 44 LEDs. So just change that and upload the code to both the Arduinos. After successfully uploading the code, you can give a small tap to the sensor to make sure it is working. And as you can see, it works flawlessly. Then I used some double tape to fix the battery behind the shoe. And this project was complete. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends and subscribe for more awesome content like this, and I will see you guys in the next one.